There's a big push at the Capitol to get rid of unnecessary laws. Governor Mark Dayton's making a major push to clean up Minnesota's law books by eliminating outdated laws and simplifying the way state government does business. Pat Kessler's at the Capitol tonight. Wow, Pat, this sounds revolutionary.
Well, a lot of people have tried it before. The governor today said he's got 1,000 ideas to make government simpler, like repealing laws that his team of commissioners called, here's quotes, ridiculous, incomprehensible, and just plain silly. Since 1937, it's been illegal in Minnesota to drive a car in neutral. There are more laws regulating the 19th century telegraph industry than there are for the internet. And don't even get started on wild boars.
If a wild boar escapes in the cities of Minneapolis or St. Paul, the commissioner of agriculture himself has to go out there and capture that wild boar.
Governor Dayton's asking lawmakers to repeal archaic statutes that litter the law books and to simplify government websites. What used to take 11 clicks at the DNR to reserve a campsite now takes only two, making for happy campers.
A lot of times we're making last minute trip decisions. We might be like, hey, let's just quick get out for a few hours, and we can do that on our phone on the go, which before we couldn't.
Very special.
The governor got the idea for an un-session from the 1980s Uncola 7-Up commercials, even ordering state employees to write memos in plain English. Republicans seized on the idea, calling for the un-session to undo tax hikes and wasteful spending.
I think what we need to undo are some of the bad decisions of the DFL control in Minnesota.
The governor's office says regular Minnesotans submitted many of the ideas for the un-session, which it compares to a government spring cleaning.
It's about cleaning up the state books and making government easier to understand and more efficient.
Well, many of the governor's ideas are far-reaching. Previously, they already cut the environmental permitting process from 2 years to 150 days. Frank, now they say they want to cut it to 90 days. So there is still a lot of material here to work with.
Yes, indeed. Pat, you highlighted the plain language for orders and state employees.
How about that?
Well, it sounds great. I mean, what does he actually want them to do?
Well, if you look at some of the letters that any of us have received from state government, I think it's fair to say many of them are incomprehensible when you look at these. So the governor is ordering state employees to write, and these are his words, in commonly understood language, and also write in short and complete sentences. I think that's something we should all probably learn how to do, but this is something the governor says they are going to train people to actually do.
Wow. All right. Well, we wish him luck.
Yeah, here we go.
All right, Pat, thank you.